Yeah, and they're not all freshmen or sophomores. Actually, we've been players and juniors and seniors in the whole line, which we haven't yet since we've been here. You know, which is good because we have to start a new quarterback, you know, or a guy that hasn't played a lot. So, you know, we're gonna need some other people to kind of help things out. You know, running back comes back, all receivers come back. So
it seems like whoever that is gonna step into a pretty decent situation in terms of people being around.
I think a lot of experience and some guys that have played, you know, in a lot of football games. You know, and some depth finally. If I don't screw them up, I think you got a chance to be all right.
Do you think your scheme can be a little forgiving for a first-year guy? It seemed like Brett really kind of came into it pretty well his first year. Do you think it can be something that's kind of easy to jump into?
Yeah, I think so, because it's a lot of easy. I mean, you can manufacture it to be very, very simple.
Right.
Right? And, you know, the guys we got here now, and New and Asante and all those guys, they've obviously been doing it for 2 or 3 years. And the guys coming in, you know, he's always got a background in it. I mean, it's not a, you guys know me, it's not a complicated offense, right? You know, it's 5 plays, call him again.
Just in order. You know?
Yeah,
just
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's your order.
1, 2, 3, 4.
No, then I go 2, 4, 3, 1, 5, and then come back to
you tend to skip the long ball down the field a lot, though.
That's not
you
it.
You jump right over.
That's 7.
That's for special occasions.
It's been like a year and a half since you've had a chance to say that.
I know. I just didn't want you to think I forgot.
Right? Have you started true freshman at quarterback before in your career?
A true freshman?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ole Miss, I started one. Yeah. But like you weren't even born.
His name Archie?
No, I'm not that old. Come on.
What was his name?
I think Romero Miller was a true freshman.
How'd you guys?
You know what? I can't say for sure. He might have been a redshirt freshman.
But he's the only candidate you can think of that might
have
been.
He's the only one I can think of. Yeah, he's the only one. It's gonna be exciting.
If a true freshman comes in, that
if
you can,
a true freshman right, comes still, in, I mean, you still got to beat up.
If you get a quarterback, if you get a quarterback in this class,
yes, yeah.
If one happens to come
if
in
one
next
happens
week,
to come in next week,
right?
Yeah.
Have you been paying close attention to some of the backup guys behind Brett in this last week or so?
Not really. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, after. No, I mean, because everybody says, well, that's a great time to work with young guys and all that kind of stuff. We're all still pretty young, so our old young guys still needed to work. And, you know, Brett was still getting over his little finger deal, you know. So, yeah, the other kids took a bunch of reps, and it wasn't like we were like, okay, we're just going to watch it. Yeah, we gave them some reps in there. They're, you know, they understand their chance. I mean, their competition comes in the spring, you know. Now it's wide open. Let's see who can play.
How clear was the hierarchy this year behind Brett, you know, having Jerry be the primary backup? Was it a pretty significant difference, you think, between Jerry and Ashanti?
Yeah, I think Jerry by far, Jerry gets it.
Right.
You know? Jerry really hasn't had a chance to be on the field and playing games, but Jerry's had a really good fall,
right.
You know, in practice and things we've asked him to do. And then after that, it's pretty much. But when you're the third guy, I mean, nobody knows who the third guy is, right? You know, it doesn't mean they could be great or not great or whatever. There's just no time to develop them or look at them.
Get nostalgic at all, knowing this is Brett's last game.
I know. I just thought about it when we were sitting up here. You know, he's been since I've been to UCLA. He's the guy who ran every play, good and bad. You know,
you're actually going to have to work for a living next year.
I know. It's kind of exciting too. You know, it's an exciting time for him to move on. I know he's tired of me. You know, he needs to move on to some other things. You know how it is. It's like your own kids, right? You know, they don't listen to you until they leave the house, and you know. I wonder if you can deposit some money in their account. And that's the only time they start listening to you. You know, because I always remember when I was at the Jets and Taylor was playing quarterback at East Carolina, right? And I'm coaching quarterbacks at the Jets, right? So he's in camp or whatever, having a bad day. He calls me up. He says, Dad, he says, You think you could get Chad Pennington on the phone with me? And I go, yeah, why? What do you need to talk to Chad about? He said, well, I want to ask him about some quarterback drills and some fundamentals I'm having problems with. You know, it's like one of those deals. You know, they stop listening to you. No, but it's you know, these guys kind of came in when we came in and helped, you know, really, like I said earlier, I really believe that kind of set, you know, Jim's culture and, you know, what we're striving to be. And we still got ways to go now. You know, we got to become more, you know, bigger physical team, you know, to get through the season and, you know.
Beat Oregon, beat Stanford.
Exactly. Exactly. You know, I mean, we're at that point, right?
Was it that much easier this year coaching Brett, or was it harder given that you have to focus on such specific things and you have to look for those things to push him?
It was harder and easier. It's easier because he knows exactly what's going on. It's harder because he's done it enough now. He has way too many of his own opinions. If you just listen to me, all right, he'd be fine.
He's not just soaking it all in.
Yeah. You know, I mean, it's like anything, right? I mean, now he has an opinion on what we should do and why we're doing this, and, you know, like they all do, right? But he's been an awesome guy to coach, you know. And like I think I was telling Chris or something earlier, is what gets lost to me. What gets lost in the whole Brett Hundley story is that is the surrounding cast that he had. Okay, I mean, it was a bunch of babies. You know, we forget that. You know, he has a bad game where he gets sacked, you know, 58 times in a season. You know, he needs to get rid of the ball. He needs his eyes to, you know, the poor kid's playing behind three true freshmen, you know, and, you know, true freshman receivers and you know, it helped. Like, you could even, like, the where I really noticed it, and that's what Paul was good for us, was our first year we had Jonathan. Mm-hmm. So Jonathan took a lot of pressure on Brett, because we could just hand to Jonathan and he'd make third downs and make things happen, make guys miss. So, you know, he had to kind of grow up like we all did with a lot of those kids on that offense. Mm-hmm.
Where do you think Jerry needs to improve the most if he is going to step in and prove himself capable of being the starter?
I don't know. We'll find out. I mean, I really can't say. Mm-hmm. You know? I mean, he's really further. I don't want to make this sound wrong, all right? But he is more than adequate. More than, you know, he has everything you need to win in this offense, I think. Mm-hmm. You know, he's really had a good fall. You know, what I like about Jerry, is he's freaking, you know, and I never coached with Rick or whatever, but Jerry's rapport with the other guys, you know, and his emotions and, you know, his excitability, and, you know, I mean, shows, you know, it's all right here, right? You always know how he's feeling. It's on his sleeve, and that's kind of cool. You kind of see his passion for it. And I think the other kids, you know, kind of saw in that Texas game. I mean, he gave a hell of a halftime speech in the Texas game now.
Coach, have you seen an evolution on how defenses try to stop Brett throughout this year, from the start of the year till now?
Defensive guys do what they do, you know. You know, they obviously had to, you know, some of this was too, you know, like I keep telling Brett, is Brett, you gotta be Brett. Don't go out there and read the, whatever the soothsayers are saying, well, he's gotta do this better, or be more like this, all right? You gotta just be Brett. So I think, you know, early in the year, he was really not using his running ability the way he should have, because he thought, oh, I gotta be a pocket passer. All right, and when he started doing that, you know, defenses do have to worry about him when he tucks the ball and takes off. You know, so yeah, maybe they make some adjustments that way. But pretty much all 3 years when we play defensive guys, defensive coordinators, they do it. You know, they do what they do, and we do what we do.
All right, thank you. Mm-hmm.
What does Brett need to work on?
I think this year was good for him. You know, obviously, there's when you listen to all the experts, I've listened. Get out of here!
Wow! Shut down.
You know, yeah.
I think you hurt his feelings in his hamstring.
His classmate. No, does he have all the physical and mental attributes? Yeah, right? Is he going to understand when he gets to the next level that this means open? Yeah, you know, which a lot of them don't understand until they get up there. You know how you got to throw guys open and how, you know, this much room is open in the NFL and I got to stick the ball in there. But that's, you know, something he'll just learn. Yeah, it'd be an easy transition for him. I think he's done a really good job of in the classroom of becoming a more of a student of the game this year than he had in the past 2 years, as far as understanding defenses, understanding rotations, understanding run fits, understanding protections, you know, the whole understanding defenses instead of just, hey, we run zone read, you know. So he's really worked hard at doing that. When he gets up to the next level, you know, the game speeds up, man. You know, he's going to figure it out. The guys that don't figure it out don't last very long. But he will, because he's a smart kid and he's got all the ability, you know, and he'll see how quickly the game moves at that level.
It seems like your advice is good for as he moves forward, be himself.
Just be Brett.
What does he do well here at UCLA? What's his strength? Is there certain passes and throws best?
No, he's got obviously arm talent. Okay, to make the throws you want. He's probably a better deep ball thrower than I allow him to be, because I don't throw deep enough times. No, he tells me this all the time. Okay. It's a running joke. Yes.
They throw the ball.
I know they do.
But actually, though, you did kind of change me a little bit a year
last
ago.
Year,
yes,
you were.
Yes, yes. Last year you did change me, yeah.
And did I get a taste of that new contract? No, I did not.
You're right. You're still buying lunch. I should be buying lunch.
My company's buying
lunch. Oh. he can make all the throws. Okay. You know, his athletic, you know, just his athletic ability. You just look at the NFL now. I mean, we're on a list of guys that I watched Andy Dalton from the Cincinnati Bengals running zone read. You know, right? You know, it's becoming a part of the NFL football. You know, I know it's not as major a part as probably we do, but we also are not just a zone read offense. I mean, he's been exposed to it. We have a lot of, you know, six-man protections, drop back. The only thing with us is he's not under center very much, so that's something he's going to have to work on. You know, three-step, five-step, seven-step, play-action stuff from under center. Okay, because he's going to probably go to some place unless he goes to Chip. All right, at Philly or something, you know, where they're going to ask him to do those type of things. So that's what he's got to work on. You know, just the footwork and the fundamentals of being an under-center quarterback. But I had one back in 03 who they said the same thing about was, man, he's never under-center, all right? Man, he'll never make it. The kid's name is Philip Rivers, right? He was a zone, you know, I ran the zone read, shotgun stuff with him. So I don't think that's something that you can't be, you know, you can't get good at it.
Okay,